Welcome back to my channel, everyone, and happy new year. This is the first video that I'm recording in 2018, so I'm super excited what this year will bring the both of us. Well, I guess it, like me and you guys, not both of us. So before we get started, I just want to tell you guys about my two New Year's resolutions. Now, the only reason I'm telling you guys these is because it has to do with the video that you're about to watch and the videos that will come after this one. So I only have two, and they didn't even start out as resolutions, because typically for me, I'll say that I'm gonna do something in the new year and then I forget about it, I go back to my old habits, and then I'm just like, oh, you know what, I'll try again next year. But this year I decided that I wanted to just change some things that I really didn't feel like were going well with my life, and one of those big things had to do with my confidence and hair care and whatnot. So I figured that I would make two for myself that I could stick with for the rest of the year that I wouldn't just throw away. My first one is to take much better care of my hair. Since I cut my hair 5 months ago, and even, actually no, it's longer than that now. It's like 6 or 7 months. My point is, since I cut my hair, even before I cut my hair, I never took the care that really needed to be done. You know, I'd wash it and, you know, not use heat and little things like that, but I never actually had a specific routine that I followed where, you know, I washed this day and I moisturized this day and I did this and did that. Like, I've never actually done that. So I really wanted to make sure that I'm taking much, much better care of my hair. In the video that you're about to watch, the wash routine that I'm about to show you guys, I did show you guys a length check, and I'll say this again, but I'm just gonna put it out there now while this is in like the intro part. Basically, I realized how long my hair had gotten, and then I realized my hair had gotten that long without a specific routine that I've been following. So I figured if I develop a routine and I, you know, develop good hair habits, that my hair will grow so much faster, healthier, and fuller. So it makes sense that, you know, I should take better care of my hair and my hair will come out a lot better. Cause I mean, it has grown, but it can just do so much more if I really take the care that, you know, needs to be done for my hair. And then my second New Year's resolution was just to try more things. It's more so meaning like towards my hair, but just in general. I am in college, which I've said that before, and I just finished my first semester. My first semester, I really just focused on my grades and just like only working on school. Like, I didn't really get out, I didn't do any type of like partying or anything like that. Like, I pretty much just stayed in my dorm and doing homework and whatever. But I'm in a totally new place, totally new people, and I just really want to feel like, you know, I want to explore more, and I know that there's so many things that I can do and so many things that, you know, there are to do. So a big thing for me is just to get out and experience more, but not only in that aspect with my hair. I want to, especially with the different lengths that my hair is at now, I really want to experience, like, try new styles and try new products and stuff with my hair. That's a huge thing for me, especially because I've realized the more, like, the better care I take of my hair and the more adventurous things that I do with my hair, the more that I actually want to go out and do things, you know? It's like, when you don't feel like you look good or like you feel good, like, you're not gonna wanna do anything. But when you feel like, oh, okay, like, I'm cute, like, I got this, and, you know, this is feeling good and this is going right, like, you're gonna wanna go out and do more. So I think that kind of, that like goes hand in hand for me, like wanting to get out and adventure with different things when I feel like I am, you know, feeling that in myself. I don't really know how to explain it. But basically, like, when you feel good and you look good, you wanna go out and go do, you know, different stuff or whatever. I guess that's how I'm explaining it. I don't know, does that even make sense? I'm not even sure that that made sense. So basically, when my hair looks good and I feel good, like, I feel good and I wanna go out and like do different things or whatever. So just trying different styles, like this one that I have. I've never done anything like this before this week, and I randomly just tried it and was like, you know what, like, I really am cute. And then it's just like so much more fun, like, trying new stuff. Like, for the longest time, I would literally wash my hair, put gel in it, put a headscarf on, and just wear it super flat. And like, it was cute and all, but like, switch it up a little bit. And especially because I have, like, it's growing, like, there are a bunch of different styles that I can try, like, at various lengths. So I think that's just a lot more fun. Yeah, like, just a lot less boring. Like, be adventurous. Don't just, I'm trying to step out of my comfort zone and not be as, basically just not be as comfortable. Like, I need to experience different things, whether it's with my hair or, you know, with my work or outside with school and like stuff like that. So basically just getting out there a little bit more so with my hair, but just in general. So I think I've covered everything. this video, I'm showing you guys a new routine that I've come up with to make sure that I'm really taking care of my hair and I have a consistent routine that I'm following. And then the next few videos will probably just be different styles that I'm trying or different things that I've come up with, different products that I've come across, just stuff like that, really trying to expand my hair care knowledge and plethora of ideas and styles that I've come across of and whatnot. I hope I really use that word right. Please be sure to like this video and comment something down below. Go follow me on Instagram at @itsima. I think it's 2 underscores actually. 2 underscores, it's Ima. I'll leave it somewhere down there or whatever. And yeah, I will see you guys in my next video. Thank you all so much for watching. My hair is going to grow a lot faster, a lot stronger, and a lot healthier. So this was, I was just showing you guys how long I have come without any type of, you know, strict process that I follow day in and day out. I want to take much better care of my hair so that way I can get to my goal faster, which is to ultimately get my fro back. I just want my long hair back. So yeah, I just want to show you guys how long my hair is getting. I'm going to go ahead and start out by conditioning my hair. I use the Mane & Tail Deep Moisturizing Conditioner. Nothing to it. My mom used to use this on me when I was younger, and then I saw it and, you know, read up about it, and it was really good for dry and damaged hair, which after all of the, you know, coloring and whatnot that I've done to it, my hair has certainly been dry and it has certainly been damaged. I like to do it before I shampoo with my other stuff because shampoo, you know, strips all those oils out of your hair. So this just kind of helps protect my hair before I shampoo it to get all the dirt out. So I'm gonna go ahead and condition my hair with this really fast. Gonna put this in there, massage it for a couple of minutes, really let it sit in there, and then I'm gonna rinse it out, and then I will come back and show you guys the conditioner that I'm gonna use. So now to actually remove the buildup in my hair, I'm using the Biotin and Collagen Shampoo. It is a thickening shampoo, so it does make your hair thicker and fuller, which is really nice. I don't really know much about collagen. I'm pretty sure it does something like good for like the elasticity of your skin or something, I don't know. But I know that Biotin is really good for strengthening hair and nails, which is why I like to use the conditioner. So I saw the shampoo this time and was like, you know what, I'll go ahead and buy it. So I'm gonna go ahead and shampoo with this, and this will just thicken my hair as it removes all the buildup, which is really nice because who doesn't want thick hair? And then, you know, my hair will be thick and strong and eventually longer. So, oh wow, that got everywhere. I'm just going to put this all over my hair. And another mini scalp massage. Well, that makes the color look like really blonde. I'm just gonna make sure that I really get this around everywhere, and then I'm just going to massage it in like, you know, anyone washing your hair would. So I'm not really gonna walk you through anything, but I am going to give myself a mini scalp massage and just really make sure that I get the product everywhere.
So I'm not really going to explain, you know, what I'm doing. I'm just massaging this into my hair and making sure that I got it everywhere. And then we're gonna, my towel fell. And then we're gonna rinse it out and condition one more time. So now that my hair is actually clean, whatever oil was left in my hair has been completely stripped away because my hair now feels super dry. So we're going to condition with the same product line, the same Biotin and Collagen Thickening Conditioner. The shampoo, the Biotin and Collagen shampoo, like really does strip my hair, which is why I make sure that I always condition beforehand. I mean, it always feels clean, but like it just feels really dry afterwards. But this does a pretty decent job of reapplying that moisture. Maybe I should do like the Biotin conditioner first and then the shampoo and then my mane and tail conditioner. I don't know. I'm just going to put this in, massage it in my hair and detangle as I did with the first conditioner. Okay, so my hair is now completely detangled and conditioned and all that good stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and finish my shower, then I'll come back and show you guys what I do with the rest of that. There was something I was gonna tell you guys, I don't remember. Oh, so I like to use warm water when I'm doing like all my other stuff, but at least for the final rinse, when I'm rinsing out the conditioner at the end of my shower, I like to do it on cold water. And that is because I try to treat my hair as I do my skin. But basically, steaming my face and putting hot water, to open up my pores, and then, you know, rinsing with cold water to close my pores. So the same thing for your hair. You know, use hot water so that all the products that you're using, you know, can get into your hair, really clean your scalp and all that good stuff. And then at the end, condition, after you've conditioned, rinse with cold water so that way you're not like stripping away all the moisture that you just put in, and so that it'll close your pores. So that way now they've trapped in all that moisture that you've just put in there. And yeah, so yeah, there's a hair in my eye. Okay, I'm gonna go shower now. So I have two more steps in my wash routine. I'm gonna move that because it's gonna bother the crap out of me. I'm not going to put a cream in my hair. I don't really feel like it. I want to see what these two products can do on their own. So for my leave-in and for the oil that I'm going to use, I have the Aloe Naturals, two of their products. I've never actually used either of these, but I'm really excited to see how well they turn out. I read some reviews and stuff, and it looks pretty decent. This is their Lemongrass Leave-In Conditioner, and this is their Essential 17 Hair Growth Oil. So of course I wanted this because it talks about hair growth, and it has 17 different essential oils in here, hence the name. I'm not going to read them all, but to name a few, it has like emu oil, olive oil, tea tree, peppermint, rosemary, sweet almond. There's a bunch of different oils in here. And then this is a leave-in conditioner, but it's all natural ingredients, which I think is pretty cool. Again, I've never used products from this company, but I'm excited to see, you know, like how it'll do. I just wanted to try out some new stuff, and especially since I'm coming up with like a new routine, I wanted some to throw in a couple of new things. So yeah, first I'm going to massage my scalp with the essential oils, and then I'm going to apply the leave-in conditioner. So we're gonna go ahead and do that really quickly. So I'm just going to spray the lemongrass leave-in all around my hair and then finger detangle, and I'm going to just finger coil my hair all the way around. That's what I've been liking lately. I like to leave it for a few days, and it's been turning out pretty nicely and holding up pretty well. So I haven't necessarily used this product with it, obviously, like I said, but the finger coil method has been doing me well this past week and a half, so I'm going to keep that going. And yeah. Okay, I forgot how long doing this actually takes. I might have to